Hello all, I welcome you to my channel. Today in this video I am going to show you how to install CodeBlocks IDE for C and C++ programming. So it might be having assignments from your college for C and C++ programming, and CodeBlocks you can use to solve those assignments. Alright, so do watch the video till the end. If you face any issues in middle, you can always comment in your comment sections and I'll try my best to help you. Now to install CodeBlocks, you need to first simply go to favorite browser. And here you need to just simply search CodeBlocks download and hit enter, and you'll be able to see this codeblocks.org. So just open this download link, and it's going to redirect to the official site of CodeBlocks. So this link I'm going to put right in your description, so you can directly use that link to land over to the official site of CodeBlocks. And here you can see we have this download the binary releases, so you need to click on that and it will show you some ad. You can always close this ad, and you can see now we are in binary releases. So here you need to scroll down and you can see that we have Microsoft Windows, right? So we are installing it for Windows, so it is important to choose one setup that supports in Windows. And another thing that is important is to download a proper exe which also has a compiler. So I'm going to recommend you to select the fourth one. So this MinGW setup. So CodeBlocks-20.03 MinGW-setup. Alright. So this exe is what we are going to download. Always remember, do not download the other one, because that other one do not contain MinGW setup. So always select the fourth one. So click on SourceForgeNet, and it's going to redirect to the official site of SourceForge, and it's going to start downloading our CodeBlocks within 5 seconds. And you can see that our CodeBlocks is rightly started downloading over here. And you can see that our CodeBlocks is rightly downloaded over here. So let's go to our download directory, and you can see we already have CodeBlocks rightly downloaded over here. So you need to just simply double click on the setup to install it locally on our system. And you need to click on yes to provide the administrative privileges, and you'll be able to see the CodeBlocks is rightly open. So welcome to CodeBlocks setup. So just simply click on next over here. So this is our license agreement. You can always read this. Click on I agree. And these are all files that it's going to install. So one thing that is important is you need to have 531.5 MB of free space on your C drive. And the next important thing is you need to have MinGW compiler suite, you know, rightly checked. Alright, so that is what I was talking about. So you need to download one exe which also contain MinGW compiler. Alright. So you can see clearly that is checked. Alright, so now just simply click on next, and here in program files it's going to create CodeBlocks folder, which is again totally fine. Click on install, and there you go. You can see our installation is rightly began, right? So it is extracting file and then it is installing it locally on our system. So this will take some time, you know, about a couple of minutes. So once we are done with this, I'm going to again back to this video. And you can see that our CodeBlocks is almost installed. It is telling whether it'd like to run CodeBlocks now. So I want to run CodeBlocks, so I want to click on yes, and you can see that our CodeBlocks is rightly started, you know, launching. So let's minimize our download directory, and here you need to just simply click on next. So click on finish. So CodeBlocks is rightly installed, and it is also detected our GNU GCC compiler, so that is our MinGW only. So everything is fine, just, you know, simply click on OK, and it's going to start launching our CodeBlocks. So there you go, you can see our CodeBlocks is rightly up and running. So you know, it is telling whether you'd like to make default ID for C and C++ source files. So you can, you know, always click on yes, associated CodeBlocks with every supported type, and click on OK. So all C and C++ files whatever lying on your directory will be running by CodeBlocks only now. So now you need to go to file and hover over new, and I'm going to create a new file, and here I'm going to select a C or C++ source file. So just simply click on go and click on next over here. So I'm going to select a C file, click on next. So you can also select C++, totally your wish. I'm going to choose C for now. Click on next, and here you need to give the file name. So let's click on this triple dot, and it will open this desktop. So on desktop I'm going to give the file name as hello only, and I'm going to save this file. So it will be hello.c. click on finish, and you'll be able to see this hello.c is rightly opened over here. And now here I'm going to write a hello world code. So I'm going to first forward it, and you can see what I have done is I'm going to, you know, written hash encode stdio.h, and then we have created an int main method, and within int main we are printing hello world, and finally we are returning 0. So why you are returning 0? Because we have created an int main method, so it expects some sort of integer to return, so we are returning 0. So after writing this much, just simply go to file and save this file, and after that you need to click on this run button in order to build your project. Click on yes, and you will be able to see that our project is rightly started building, and after successfully get builded, it will be going to show you the output hello world on our console, right? So in this way, you can easily install CodeBlocks on Windows operating system. Please do like, share and subscribe. That will really motivate me to make more such videos. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.